In this teaching tip video, you will learn about active learning so that you can effectively teach this concept in your own courses. We will cover four different steps of one method of active learning: reading, lecture and quiz, assessment, group discussion and assessment, and class discussion and answer. Let's get started, shall we? Active learning involves participating, collaborating with others, and applying knowledge in the real world. When learning, it's normal for learners' brains to ask two questions: do I understand this, and do I need to know this? Understanding requires some prior knowledge. If there is none, then the brain doesn't know what to do with the new knowledge, so it deletes it. So, it's important for new knowledge to be attached to a learner's prior knowledge so that their brain knows what to do with it. Similarly, the brain will separate new knowledge into two groups: needed and unneeded, and the unneeded knowledge will be deleted as well, while the needed knowledge will be retained, especially if it is revisited on an occasional basis. Step number one: reading, lecture, and quiz. In this first step, students are introduced to the learning content through a variety of sources such as reading, lectures, videos, etc. After that, they are given a simple quiz in order to assess their comprehension while reinforcing their new knowledge. This step is the introductory stage where students are given an opportunity to develop a knowledge base to build upon. Step number two: assessment. In this next step, students are asked a specific question about the learning content, which is comprehension based, not just memory based. In other words, their answer requires them to calculate their answer instead of just recalling information. Step number three: the group discussion and assessment. In this next step, students are broken into small groups so that they can argue for the answer to the question. They have to explain why their answer is correct and why their classmates' opposing answers are incorrect. Afterwards, they are tested on their answers to the same question individually. This step strengthens students' understanding of the learning content and reinforces their retention of the learning content. Step number four: class discussion and answer. In this next step, the instructor leads the class in a discussion on the question so that all students can explain their reasons for their answer. Only at the end does the instructor give the correct answer to the students, followed by a Q&A session. This method of active learning works because students develop a stake in the answer to the given question by arguing their reason from the beginning. In other words, their brains decide that this information is important and should be remembered. Also, by discussing their answer in smaller as well as larger groups, they dig deeper into the information and actually build new pathways in their brains to this new and important information. By this time, they have developed a strong foundation of prior knowledge to build upon and are far more open to the instructor's answer when, in the end, it is finally delivered to the class. In this video, we covered four different steps of active learning: reading, lecture and quiz, assessment, group discussion and assessment, and class discussion and answer. Now that you know more about active learning, you should be better prepared to teach about it in your courses. Good luck!